everyone. I'm Jenna Phillips with VelveTv, and we're at the Grove in LA, and do we have a surprise in store for you. I am standing next to powerhouse Frenchie Davis, everybody. Frenchie, congratulations on your success on The Voice.
Thank you.
What was it like working with Christina Aguilera?
The whole experience was just amazing, and not just getting to know Christina, but getting to know the other coaches as well. I mean, CeeLo and Adam, you know, I've built like a little miniature love affair with them. I love them dearly, and even Blake, like, bonded with him and Miranda a little bit at our rap party, and so just the whole experience, being able to share a stage with, you know, those amazingly successful artists, and making building lifelong friendships with some of the amazing singers that I shared the stage with. So it was just an amazing experience overall.
Now, I know there's got to be some funny moments on this show. You always referred to your team as a diva team. Why was that?
And well, no, people refer to our team as a diva team.
Okay.
We never really had to say it. Other people said it. We kind of got dubbed that at the beginning of...
Why do you
think
that
blind auditions? I think because a lot of people consider Christina Aguilera to be a diva, and you know, she picked a lot of girls who had diva voices to be on her team, so
yeah.
I think that's why they called it the diva.
I mean, you really gave her a run for the money. I mean, I was watching you on Lady Marmalade. I loved it. You were amazing.
Thank you.
So you're hot off The Voice now.
Yes.
Any plans in the works for a new album?
Yes, I am working on that right now. You know, I've never recorded an album, and so I am taking advantage of this opportunity to finally do that, because it's something that I've always wanted to do. And I'm also still doing acting as well. I just got cast in a film. It's a comedy. And I recently found out that Tom Arnold and Carl Reiner will be in the cast.
Wow! So really, congratulations!
Thank you.
Can
so
you
much.
Share with us a little bit about the character you're going to be playing?
Yeah, it's hilarious.
Yeah.
I'm playing an office receptionist who was also the face of a religious cult where all of the members are bald.
Oh, wow! That does sound funny.
Doesn't that sound funny?
Yeah.
And I think Carl Reiner might be playing the leader. I'm not sure. So it's going to be, it sounds hilarious. And I mean, the people that they've cast thus far, you know, further prove that it's probably going to be hilarious. So I'm really excited, and I'm just taking advantage of every opportunity that presents itself, and enjoying the ride.
That's wonderful.
Yes.
You know, you're kind of like the comeback kid. You've been a big inspiration to a lot of kids and a lot of adults, and including myself.
Wow, thank you.
What would you say to someone that might be considering giving up on their dreams?
You know, you just can't give up. And we're human, and it's normal to have those moments where you feel like you want to. But you have to ask yourself, if I quit, am I deserving of everything that I want?
That's a very good
and
question.
It's like, if you believe that you deserve what you want out of life, then you have to fight for it. And that's just the way life is. You're going to have to fight for it. And one of my favorite phrases is, when they close the door on you, go through the damn window. You just never quit.
That's good. Yeah. I like that a lot.
You know, I was watching the BET Awards the other day, and the most amazing performance of the night was Kelly Rowland. And I thought, how inspiring and empowering is that? You know, and it's like, people can say what they want, and they, you know, jokingly have referred to their singing group as Beyonce and them, and, you know, just kind of tried to dumb down the artistic contributions of the other members of the group. And it's like, Kelly just kept on going, and it's like, she's got one of the number one, you know, one of the top songs in the country right now. And her performance was amazing. And what I loved about it was that she was covered from head to toe and was the sexiest girl to hit the stage that night.
I love that. That's a big point.
And so she's another person who I think every day is proving with her career that you just don't give up. And it doesn't matter what people think or, you know, what they perceive necessarily, because you have the power to prove them wrong. You let your work speak for you. You let your work ethic speak for you.
That's very inspirational.
Thank you,
Frenchie. Could you take us out with a little song of what we're going to be hearing tonight at the Grove?
Let's see. What am I doing? Oh, okay. Let's see. Clock strikes on the hour, and the sun begins to fade. Spending a long time to figure out how to chase my blues away. I done right up till now. It's the light of day that shows me how. So when the night falls, my lonely heart calls.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Frenchie Davis, and you're watching Velvet TV.